Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Silvey, High Level Queen, and today we are going to talk about how to use the brand new calendar that just came out inside of High Level. And this new calendar really embraces the functionality to use Teams and round robins in your appointments. So yes, after you follow the steps in this video, you can go cancel your Calendly account. Let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Okay, so first things first, we're just gonna explain real quick what happened to your existing calendars. So if you go to settings and then calendars, you can see all of your old calendars here and they're all gonna say unassigned. That is because all the new calendars are based upon teams, okay? So what I mean by that is, let's say that you have a sales team and that you have three people on your sales team. Well, now you'll be able to automatically assign these leads in a round robin fashion to each one of those different salespeople. Or you can set up different services now, okay? So in this video, I'm actually going to show you real time me converting my calendar into a services-based calendar. So people who book an appointment with me will be able to pick between a free consult and a paid consult, for example. And you can use this for your med spa services or your estimate, home services, different kinds of estimates. All those services take different amounts of time, okay? So that's the great thing. Now you can actually have multiple services and not have to create a different calendar for each one, okay? So I'm gonna show you guys in real time how to do that. So the first thing that you're gonna have to do is, if you don't have any users set up in your High Level account, you wanna go ahead and do that, because it's not gonna work right if you don't. So go to settings and then go to team management. And then you're going to add an employee. So make sure that you have all your employees basically in the users section. And I have another video I can link to on how to do the users, but you're going to want to make sure that you set them up in here, okay? Now, I'm going to assume that you pretty much already have the users set up. So we're going to go ahead and go to Teams. So step two, you want to go to Teams, and you're gonna add a team, okay? Now here, team info, add a team name. So I'm just gonna put, since I'm doing this for my own calendar, I'm just gonna put Christine's calendar, and then I'm going to check my name. And then here in the team configuration, I'm just gonna do Christine's calendar again, and speak with the queen. You can also do a unique slug, okay? And then you can assign the contacts to the team member once they book an appointment on the calendar. So if you have a sales team, that would actually be a good thing to check. But since this is just me, I'm not gonna do that, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and save it. Now, you can see here that the team has been set up. All right, so step three, we're gonna actually go back into the calendars that we were in before, and we're gonna add, you can see the new team here, okay? So we're gonna add a calendar based on the new team, and this is the new format. So you're going to go in here and you're gonna add your name. This is like the same kind of stuff that we had before, just now separated into three different pages. Okay. All right, so you can choose a color. I always like to put, and whatever the location or company name is here, because it just says their name and they're like, I have an appointment with myself. That's weird. Now, this is new here, so we're going to talk a little bit about the difference between optimized for availability and equal distribution. Optimize for availability means that you can set the priority. So let's say you have multiple people on your sales team and one of them is like your main closer. So you would set them on high priority. And then if you had another person that was like your secondary closer, you could set them on low priority. Okay. So that's what that does. And then equal distribution just means that it's going to give equal priority to each person. So you can either set the priority here and you can put the Zoom link here, or you can do equally and then you don't need to mess with it. Or go into my custom values and grab Christine's Zoom, put that there. And then we're gonna go save and continue. I don't really want two slugs. I'm just gonna do like one. Okay. And then this is the second page availability. I've got another video that goes through all the options on this because none of this is actually new. But what is new is here, down here at the bottom, you can add days, you can subtract days, but the coolest part about this is, let's say you want 9 to 5, you can just hit apply all and it'll automatically apply to all the days. That is my absolute favorite new feature here, okay? So we're gonna do Monday, Thursday, and Friday. And then we're gonna say from noon to 5, and then Friday noon to 3, okay? And then that's just me putting my hours in there. And then the third page here, you can actually have a qualification form if you want to set that up. There's another video on that. Or if you actually choose a qualification form, you can't use sticky contact anymore. And then you can also enable the Stripe payment, okay? This is the same as before. It just used to be a toggle button, auto confirm, gonna keep that on. Send appointment alert emails to the assigned team member, gonna keep that on. Allow Google Calendar to send invitation. I want Google Calendar to send a calendar invite, but then I'm gonna disable reschedule and cancellation. And then here, pixel, you always wanna make sure you put your pixel in there. But then here you can actually redirect. This is what they used to see before, but I'm actually gonna send them to a funnel that I have set up where they can join our group and all that jazz. So I'm gonna send them here, okay? And then we're gonna go ahead and complete that. So now you can see that I've set up my calendar, and when I click on it, now it shows in this format, okay? Okay, so that's great. Let's say that I have a free consult, that one's done, but then let's say that I have a paid consult. So what I can actually do here is I can say free consult, okay? I'm gonna just rename it so I know what it is. And then here, I'm gonna say paid consult. Okay, and then I'm just gonna put 2. And I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go back and get my custom value. That way, if my link ever changes, I only have to change it in one place here. But then what I'm gonna do differently is the paid consult is gonna be an hour, okay? And then the minimum scheduling notice, I want like 6 hours, And then here, I'm going to do the same hours as far as availability, but then Friday. And then I'm going to, the difference here is now I say use Stripe payment. Oh, what? What? What's this? What's this, Christine? Well, I'm going to show you. So let's say that that's not working. There we go. All right, turn these off. Then this, you can actually send them to a different page. So I have a paid consult page. Okay, so I went and found my payment funnel, and I'm just gonna send them to the thank you step on the next page. Then they can actually like schedule an appointment with me on the right calendar. So then you want to put your pixel. Okay. So now I have two services on my calendar, a free consult and a paid consult. So I'm going to click on this link here, and there you can see that I have both options. So there is 30 minutes, and from 12 to 3, 12 to 5, perfect. Then you can click on back and look at the paid consult. It's an hour. Let's just show you what this looks like. See the time zone automatically. It knows my time zone. And then here, look, you'll be billed for this appointment. What? That's so cool, right? Like, they can put their card in there and submit the meeting, okay? Now, that is how you do the new calendar. You can get the calendar code now a different way too. So you want to click on calendar code, and then here you choose the team, and here you choose the calendar. You can link directly to each service if you want, or you can just do the top level. So this code here is what you can actually embed into any site. You can embed it into a funnel. You can embed it into a completely non-high level. You can do like a regular website, WordPress, whatever. But that's your code that you need to embed the calendar into a page, all right? And create a new team. So let's say that I'm going to say sales team and David and Heidi. And then here, speak. All right. Okay. And then I want to assign, or if I want to assign the contacts to each team member, I can. And then skip assigning contact if the contact already has an assigned user. That's pretty self-explanatory, but I'm going to leave both of them off. Then I would go back into the calendars, and now I can create a new calendar based on like either availability or equal distribution, like we talked about earlier, okay? So let's say that we want Heidi to get most of the calls because she's doing our pre-qualification. And then if she's busy, they go to David, right? So that's how that works. Then you would just complete the setup as you normally do. And there aren't any other additional options if you have the team, just basically these two. Okay, and a little added bonus, the calendar sync has completely relocated. So the way that you find that is you go into your settings and your team management, and now it's going to be underneath the user of the calendar, okay? So click edit next to the user, and then you're going to scroll down to user calendar configuration, and you can see here that you can set a primary calendar for that user. And here, this is just turning off the sync completely. And this is a read and write sync, okay? So it's a little bit different. They took away the old options. This is sync, and this is don't sync at all, okay? And then you can also, here, if you choose one of these, then that's going to turn on the two-way, essentially. So I don't have that set here. So, and then you can check for conflicts as well. So you can actually check multiple calendars for conflicts. So now if you have a personal calendar and a work calendar and you want to check both of them for conflicts, you can sync it and then choose it here, which is actually a really cool feature. So that's how you do the sync now. So I hope that helps you guys learn how to set up the brand new calendar in HighLevel, and go do this and go cancel Calendly, get out of there. And thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe so you don't miss any future updates from me. And go check out our website, digitalagencyhacker.com, your one-stop shop for all the agency resources you need, from snapshots to pitch decks to funnels. We have it all there.